What's up guys, Ibra here with HardwareCanucks, and I wanted to make this quick video regarding Intel's upcoming 8th generation CPUs. The reason why we wanted to post this video is to clear some misconceptions about these upcoming products, but also explain to you guys what the difference is between 8th generation CPUs versus Kaby Lake or 7th generation products. Now, quick disclaimer, we still have no information regarding Intel's upcoming Coffee Lake CPUs. We might share a few information here and there in this video, but we just have to wait for the specs and all that kind of stuff later down the road. But as of right now, this video is just going to go quickly over Intel's upcoming 8th generation CPUs into Ultrabooks. And guys, I have to admit, the specs are really, and I mean really, interesting. So let's dive in right after this.
Cooler Master Master Keys keyboard lineup is now available in three sizes to fit within your space, with large, medium, and small boards with either beautiful RGB or pure white LED illumination. A little something for everyone. Make it yours with the Master Keys Pro by Cooler Master.
So let's have a quick refresher about what Intel's 8th generation core series involves, since things are pretty different this time around. It used to be that each generation was tied together with specific architecture. For example, the 7th generation held exclusively Kaby Lake chips, while the 6th generation was Skylake. Shifting beyond the 14 nanometer manufacturing process has been proven to be a challenge, so basically we now have an architecture change following optimizations on that architecture without switching processing nodes. That means Skylake, Kaby Lake, and other refreshes are all the same 14 nanometer manufacturing process. Basically, Intel's 8th generation will include three different refreshes, new Kaby Lake processors, Coffee Lake, and even Cannon Lake. Expect to hear more information about Coffee Lake in the fall, and we'll be covering that architecture in depth very soon. This release follows their new naming scheme by introducing a new set of Kaby Lake processors for the slim and light Ultrabook range. Intel is calling these newer 8000 series processors Kaby Lake R, and honestly, I'm pretty excited for them. But why is Intel targeting Ultrabooks with this refresh? Well, the simple answer to that is the majority of consumers heavily rely on these products. Students, professors, business professionals use these devices on a regular basis to get work done. In fact, I use this LG Gram 15 every day to log benchmarks, write scripts, consume content, and in some cases even edit videos. Our day one RX Vega coverage back in LA is a testament to that, since it was all edited, produced, and rendered on an Ultrabook that weighs a bit more than a soda can. Also, over the past few years, we've only seen a minimal improvement in terms of performance from one generation to the next. In fact, we did test out the ultra low voltage U-series Skylake versus Kaby Lake CPUs and noticed roughly 9 to 15% increase in raw performance. So it wasn't really worth upgrading from Skylake to Kaby Lake unless if you really needed that extended battery life, because Kaby Lake chips were known for having better power efficiency. If you're interested in that comparison video, I'll leave a link to that in the description down below. So what exactly are these new 8th generation mobile CPUs called? At least the lower end SKUs that we're discussing today. Well, you can address them as Kaby Lake Refresh, or like I said, Kaby Lake R, because they're essentially using a refined and matured 14 nanometer manufacturing process compared to Kaby Lake. There's also some minor design changes that allow for better performance per watt. Intel says that the new notebooks will feature CPUs based off this 14 nanometer plus technology. That means a more power efficient node that allows them to jam four cores onto an ultra low voltage package without increasing its TDP, versus the dual core 7th generation processors. Basically, these new i7 and i5 series CPUs will have up to 4 cores and 8 threads while boasting a TDP of around 15 watts. That's really amazing, since it could really enhance performance without sacrificing battery life. It's like a dream come true. I don't know, but let's take a look at some specs. Just to be clear, all 4 SKUs that we're looking at today feature 4 cores and 8 threads. Starting from the top, we have the i7-8650U CPU that comes with a base clock of 1.9 GHz and turbo boosts up to 4.2. It also comes with 8 MB of cache, so that's doubled up compared to last gen. However, it still seems to be using the same integrated graphics, except they have renamed it from HD to UHD, implying these new CPUs can easily play back 4K content without breaking a sweat. I'll have to test that for myself, of course. Moving down the line, we have the i7-8550U that's clocked at 1.8 GHz for base and boost up to 4 GHz. It still carries the same amount of cache from the 8650U. The i5-8350U is clocked at a base of 1.7 GHz and goes all the way up to 3.6 GHz. So the boost frequency is quite lower compared to the i7s, and the cache has been reduced to 6 MB. They still feature the UHD 620 graphics, but they are 50 MHz underclocked. Last but not least, we have the i5-8250U CPU, sporting a base clock of 1.6 GHz with a turbo boost up to 3.4, and the rest of the specs are identical to the 8350U. What's even impressive is that the TDP on these new processors remain at or slightly above 15 watts. So regardless of those two additional cores, Intel claims up to 10 hours of battery life. Like everything else, we'll have to validate that when we get our hands on the new Ultrabooks, so stay tuned for that. One thing I have to mention is that Intel has achieved their excellent TDP and battery values by drastically separating the speeds achieved by single and all-core performance. On the desktop, we're used to seeing a few hundred megahertz, but in this case, the delta is several gigahertz. Basically, Intel is prioritizing multiple threads over raw frequencies when an application determines all 8 threads are needed. But what about availability of the products? Well, Intel claims that we'll see over 145 designs in September, and Kaby Lake will be coming to the desktop very soon as well. We can't wait to see what Intel has to offer, especially with Ryzen putting on some pressure lately. So, what can we take away from this announcement from Intel? Well, there are a few things. One, the specs on paper look very promising for users who are looking to upgrade their 2 or 3 or even 5-year-old notebooks. Even our main editor-in-chief, Mike, aka SkyMTL, has been using his 5-year-old Veo Z as his notebook. And so, you know, seeing these specs would perhaps make him upgrade to a newer notebook very soon. I really don't know. Also, remember that quad-core CPUs were launched into mainstream notebooks ever since Intel's second-generation core series. So it's, you know, it's awesome to see them finally implement those quad-core chips, or not those chips, but quad-core architecture into Ultrabooks, and I'm really excited for that. This is also an excellent glimpse into what 8th-generation desktop CPUs are going to look like, and I'm just going to leave it right there. So I want to hear your thoughts on Intel's upcoming 8th-generation U-series processors. Are you excited for this over the desktop or even the processors getting into the mainstream notebooks this fall? Let us know in the comments down below. I'm Ibo with HardwareCanucks. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to stay subscribed to the channel for more upcoming content, and we'll see you in the next one.